Hello, I'm Tim Bowler, English author of River Boy and about 20 books for children and young adults. I want to talk to you about Swallows and Amazons by Arthur Ransom. It has to be my favourite book ever. I first read it when I was 10, and it completely captured and entranced me from the start. And so did the other books by Arthur Ransom in the series. All 12 of them are magical and precious to me. I suppose it's fair to say that Swallows and Amazons and the others dominated my life and my reading experience from the age of about 10 until 15, I suppose, and they have stayed with me ever since. I'm now 67, and they have the same kind of magic, and I still pick them up. I still want to read them. What I love about Swallows and Amazons, looking back, is the way that Arthur Ransom gives us fiction within fiction. We have the outer fiction of children sailing on the lake in northwest England. And then we have the inner fiction, which is the children's own fiction, their own storytelling. Because to them, they are not children sailing on a lake in England. They are explorers. They are pirates. And the geography is not northwest England, but it's completely changed to what they want it to be. It's the high seas. You have the North Pole. You have Amazon, the Amazon River. You have Rio. You have Kanchenjunga. All kinds of things have changed to suit their own vision of their story. And the people, too, are also changed. The local farmers and farmers' wives become natives. The man in the houseboat becomes a retired pirate. And so the story unfolds with this wonderful, beautiful charm to it that never lessens throughout the whole of the series. So it's a special book for me. I will always, always love it. And I'm not the only older person still loving it, I know, because I only recently met a gentleman in his 90s who told me that he read the book as a small boy during the Second World War. And it was a comfort to him because bombs were falling on London during the Blitz. And he was a small boy in a dark cellar, frightened. And Arthur Ransom's book helped him. And he told me that it helps him now too. As he comes to the end of his life, he finds a new kind of solace in the same book. And that, I think, is the measure, isn't it, of a great piece of writing. Thank you for listening.